Thank you for joining me. I wanted to show everyone a quick and easy feature to add scroll buttons to your web pages. You'll notice here I've got a mobile page style, and it's kind of an example of what a mobile phone screen might look like. And you'll notice as I scroll down, you'll see that these scroll buttons appear down here at the bottom. And if I scroll back up to the top, you'll notice they disappear. And what these are good for is, imagine if you had a long web page here and you were scrolling with your thumbs or your fingers on a mobile device, and it would be a lot easier if you want to go back up to the top to just be able to click the button and it would just take you back up to the top of the page. Likewise, if you click the scroll down button, it would take you to the very bottom of that page. So it's a nice little feature to have, and I'm going to show you how you can add it to your live site pretty easily. You'll notice I've linked off to the actual code that you can cut and paste into your live site. But let me go ahead and show you where that code goes so that you can set this up. And again, you can do this for one specific page or page style to all the pages on your site. You can make it for your desktop or mobile, or make it for just your mobile pages. So it can be handy either way. But mobile page styles are usually the best place for this kind of feature. Okay, so let me show you real quick how to do that. I'm going to pull up a full screen here, and I'm logged into my live site. I'm going to go to my pages, and I'm going to go to my home page. This is the page that we were actually just looking at. And you'll notice if I go into mobile preview mode, this is the same kind of screen that we were just looking at. And you'll notice that the scroll bars, they show up here, but that's just because it's going to put those in the physical window. So as a mobile screen, those will go over to the middle of the screen. So the first thing I want to do is I need to add something to my theme so that this will work. So what I've done is I've made a copy of the Oxy theme. I haven't made any other changes except for this one change. I went into the advanced styling, and I'm scroll down to the bottom here, and I've added this code right here to the bottom. And that code basically says the width and height and where exactly the button's going to be placed. And you can, of course, mess with this as well if you wanted to, or change out the buttons, that sort of thing, to match your design. But this is kind of how the buttons get styled and appeared. So you'd want to save that. So that's the first step. The next step I want to do is actually go make sure that I've got my images there. So if I go under my design files, you'll see that I've uploaded these two images, which will also be linked to the information that's posted on the site. So you can grab these same images, or you can create your own. Make sure they're in a public folder, of course, so that they can be accessed by anybody. All right, and so I've got my files, and I've got it in my design of my theme. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my page, and I'm going to edit my page style. And in here, I want to edit the head tag area of my page style. And this is where I'm going to add some JavaScript. And what this does is this actually calls a built-in what we call jQuery, which does all the animation. It's what makes the buttons appear and disappear when you scroll on the page. And so you don't really have to know what this does. You don't have to change any of this. Just paste that in to the head area there and save and return. And that will put it in your page style. So you'll want to put it in all the page styles where you want that to appear for any page that uses that page style. You'll notice I put it in my mobile page style here. So it's not actually going to work on my desktop, which is by design. Of course, you could add it to your desktop page style as well if you wanted to do that. So now that I've got it in my page style, the last thing I want to do is set where my anchor points are. So you'll notice as these buttons show up, if I click here, it's like, where is that going? You think it's the top of the page, but it really could go to the middle of the page. It could go anywhere. Let me show you how that works. So I'm going to go into edit mode here, and I'm going to go edit the site header. This is where I actually placed it. And I actually placed this little anchor tag, I'm going to highlight it right here, into this area. So that's going to say, when they click the scroll up button, take me to wherever this code is on the page. So I happen to place it at the top, so it's going to basically take my cursor here, and since I can't go any higher on the page, it's going to appear to take me to the very top of the browser page. And likewise, I'm going to go ahead and go down to the bottom here, and I dropped the other one right here at the bottom of designer region. So you can put it in a designer region or a common region if you want to. You want these to go across your site. These happen to be in the header footer areas for the mobile for my mobile page styles, my mobile common regions, designer regions. So I only have to place these in one place and they'll work across all of the mobile pages on my site. So that's the scroll down. So that gives it the location. When I click this button, it takes me there. And of course, since I'm already there, it does nothing, which is what it should do. Once it goes to the top, of course, it will disappear. And that's part of that jQuery that we added to our page style to tell it how to operate. So that's pretty much all you have to do that. So I encourage you to give that a shot. You really can't hurt anything by trying it. So try that out and see how that works for you. Thanks for watching.